Today we are starting a new chapter, that is current electricity. We have studied about electrically charged particles, electric field, electric potential, and the forces being applied on the charges due to other charges. Now, if there is an electric field and there is a charge in that electric field, it is experiencing a force. And if we do not cancel out that force with any other force, then what will happen? That net force always creates an acceleration, and net force is responsible for motion of that particle. So that particle start moving. Suppose there is a large number of charged particles and they are in a body, they are lined up in electric field, then they keep on moving. I have this one copper strip or copper wire which is very long. In this I have connected with a source here, and there is an electric field in it. If there is an electric field in it and there is a particle which has got charge Q, every conductor has large number of charge particles. What will happen to these charge particles? Answer, all will experience a force QE, and because of that force they will start moving. And when they move, the charges move, they show many characteristics, and this we are going to study here. But first, when the charges move, then we have to discuss, we have to fix up many quantities which are related to motion of the charges. Like if one charge is moving, if two charges are moving, if five charges are moving, how we will differentiate? If charge is moving with a speed 1 millimeter per second, if it is moving with a speed of 10 millimeter per second, then what will happen? So first we have to fix up certain terms in this. Okay, the very first thing, what is meant by electric current? Like water current, which is closely related to the word flow. Anything which flows makes current. So if the charges are moving, then we can say moving charged particles make current or electric current. Moving charged particles make electric current. Why they should move? We will come to that. I have told you, because there is electric field, they move. And electric field creation, we can always create a electric field by using certain methods. Okay, so moving charged particles make electric current. Now, this electric current has got strength. We have to fix up that, what do we call strength of electric current. To count the strength of electric current, we put a gate here. Imagine we have a gate here and we start counting. Count. What do we count? How many charges jump over this gate? How many cross this gate in 1 second? So this is cross section, the charges passing this at in 1 second will be the strength of electric current. Like very simple, in a if in a river the water current is less and water current is more, how we can measure it? Stand here, see here, measure here. In 1 second 100 liter water is going. In one case, in other case, in 1 second 500 liter water is going. Maybe the speed of water is more, maybe its volume is more, maybe anything. But in 1 second, if more water is going, we say the current is high, the current is heavy. Similar term here. So we make a definition that in any conductor, the number of charges or intensity of electric current, and this we will denoted by I. So important words: electric charge, 1 second. Suppose in time t the charge passing is q, then in 1 second how much charge will pass? Q upon t, and this we will call current. So this is our first formula we get in electric current. Electric current is equal to q upon t, where q is the charge flown in how much time? T. And where is it flowing? In any conductor. And how do we count? Through any cross section at any one point. So this becomes the condition of electric current. So once again, what is electric current? Electric current is the flow of charge. Why the charges should flow? There has to be an electric field which will promote, or which will be the cause of electric current. So cause of electric current, cause of current is electric field. So in next lecture we will study who carries the charge, what are the charge carriers, and who are the charge carriers in different material, and how they are related, and what is the velocity of electrical charge carriers, and how this velocity is developed. From where do we get charge carriers? That we will do in the next lecture.